Hey everyone, this is Team MY131. My name is Wenda, and this project is under a collaboration with Hospital Umum Sarawak. And this project actually started since 2017 when we heard a story from an ONG specialist. She described the problem can be separated into four of them. The first one is born before arrival. So as you can see from here, this is a case that actually happened back in 2017 in Petaling Jaya, where a baby actually born inside of Grab car, and this baby actually get a lifetime free ride of Grab. And unfortunately, the same case actually happened in the same year, but this time the baby died. So you can see that this problem does not only happen in Malaysia, but also happens around the world in US and Thailand. And this actually has a relation to the next problem, which is forced labor alarm. And because a lot of mothers, including young mothers, when something happens on their tummy during the pregnancy, so they will rush to the hospital. And this case actually can lead to the next problem, which is the overloaded hospital. As you can see from here, this is the case, the situation back in 2017 in Public Hospital Klang Valley. The bed occupancy rate, BOR, has exceeded 100%. And I'm pretty sure that most of us already understand that because of the pandemic currently, most of the hospitals are in the overloaded situation as well. And the fourth problem is fetal distress. So as you, ladies and gentlemen, do you know that oxygen deprivation is one of the top 10 leading causes of infant mortality? And this happens in every 12% of deliveries. And out of that 12%, there is a 75% chance of causing a perinatal death. And this number can actually convert into, out of 12 babies, 9 of them will most likely to die. And 3 of those who survive might have a permanent brain damage as well. So, as you can see from here, this is from the World Health Organization. According to them, the pregnant ladies are actually one of the high-risk group in this pandemic because of their change in their body during the pregnancy. And according to an interview with the ONG specialist, she actually described that currently, they are, because of the COVID-19 pandemic, they're trying to minimize the number of patients in the ward. So because first of all, in the pandemic, then second of all, the hospital is almost overloaded already. So they are looking for some way to monitor the baby wirelessly. So as you can see, this is a conventional CTG machine that we have right now. They are actually non-invasive and accurate. But you can also know that they are actually quite complex to set up and require an expert to operate it. So we propose a solution where we use a phonocardiography sensor to record the fetal heartbeat sound in acoustic form, as well as a tachodynamometer to record the uterine contraction. The signal will then send to the mobile phone. The mobile phone will upload to the cloud AI. The cloud AI will analyze the data, and then they return the result to the mother so that the mother can know the status of the mother of the baby. And just to be sure, we also send a copy of the signal to the authorized doctor so that they can analyze themselves when they are free. And they can also verify the AI prediction, whether it is a correct prediction or it is a false prediction, so they can notify the mothers. So you may ask, why us? Actually, you can see that we actually featuring immediate assessment, and we allow expert to remote monitoring the patient. And our method is non-invasive, and we have an AI-based prediction as well. So, and then we allow the mothers to self-monitor themselves at home, and the setup is actually easy to set up. So before we continue to the demo, I would like to show you this is the first prototype that we built, but we move on to phonocardiography because the first method actually very hard for us to detect the fetal signal. And in this demo, we are going to focus more on the software side that we built around Azure and MATLAB. So we compare the performance of the phonocardiography with the common method, which is ECG, in predicting the heart rate in both ideal and noisy cases. So you can see that if we take the ECG as the benchmark, we can see the average highest error, also 6.65 error percent only. And it also built an automated CTG interpretation system where you can see this is the data cleaning process, and we also extract the features like baseline, acceleration and deceleration from the some variability in the fetal heart rate. And then after we extract all the features, we can feed into the cloud AI that we built using Microsoft Azure. And in this case, we're using multi-class decision forest. That's our classifier, and we predict it and train it, and we get an accuracy of 94.1%. And with the confusion metric, you can see that we have majority of the data has been predicted correctly in normal, pathologic, and suspect classes. So in this project, we managed to automate the CTG interpretation process as well as using machine learning for the CTG analysis. And because we are using Microsoft Azure, we can deploy the trained model as a web service as well. In this project, we also identified that the phonocardiography can perform as well as the ECG, especially in noisy cases. And so what's next? What's next is to put everything together, build a new hardware, and possible, we can go through a pre-clinical trial like Cerium IC606012 or clinical trial like ethical approval and stuff like that, all under MDA approval, which might take around 1 to 1.5 years. And if we are looking for us to go overseas, we can also look for the FDA approval as well. So that's all for our presentation. Thank you.